In this video, I'm going to show you how to thoroughly clean these refillable perfume atomizers. Now, if you watched the previous video that I did on how to actually fill them, you'll know how easy they are to use and also how useful they are. With them being only 5 mil, you can take them on board a plane, you can put them into your handbag, you can put them into your pocket, you can even fill them with mosquito repellent if you're going out on a night when you're on holiday. So really, really useful, but you do get a buildup of perfume or aftershave on them, so you do need to clean them. And not only that, you may want to change the perfume or aftershave that's in there. And if you're doing that, you really want to remove all traces of the previous perfume that you've had in there. So there's two main ways to clean these. One's with water and soap, and the other one is with rubbing alcohol. I'm going to go through both of the processes just to show you how easy it actually is. We'll start off with the water and soap one first. All you need to do this method is basically an empty bottle. You pick these up for pennies at the pound shop or the dollar shop. And what you need to do is pull the top off it, and you'll see the pump on top. Open it up, then get some water, pour that into it. You don't need too much. A little bit of water. Now, because there's oils in perfume, using just water really isn't going to be that beneficial. So you do need to use a bit of liquid soap. If you just pop that in, not too much, just enough. Pop that to one side. Put the top back on and just give it a little bit of a shake. You don't need it foamy. Once that's in there then, get your empty refillable and simply do exactly the same as you did when you filled it with perfume. You just pump it. And you can see it filling up there. And when it's in, you can see it. Just give it a shake. Take the top off. And then just spray that out. And you just repeat the process until you can't smell anything as it's coming out. So we'll do that again. Get it. Half fill it. That's half full. Give it a shake again. And spray it out. I can still smell it. You're probably going to want to do this at least 4 or 5 times just to get everything out. And then once you've done that, what I'd recommend is with the same soapy water, just give the casing a spray and the lid just to get rid of everything, all the smell from the previous liquid that's been in it. Give it a good wipe down. Something you do need to do though, once you've rinsed it out 4 or 5 times with the soapy water, empty the soapy water out, put fresh water in, and then just repeat it a couple of times. You don't want any soapy water in there. Just spray it all through, give it a good clear out. Something else you're going to do as well, no matter which way you use, once it's been thoroughly cleaned through inside and you clean the outside, what I'd definitely recommend you do is that you pull the head off like that, because you're going to have a build-up of perfume or aftershave inside there and also inside there. So give that a really good clean as well. Then just pop it back on. And then that's it, all clean and ready to refill with your favourite scent. Now it works, and it works really well. However, I've got a favourite technique, and it's not with soap and water, but if that's all you've got, then that does work. My preferred method of cleaning these is with rubbing alcohol. And the main reason for that is it's quicker, and I think it's more effective as well. So you get rubbing alcohol, which is basically everything that was used during coronavirus. And to clean it with this, all you do is literally take the top off, take the squirty top off, and just fill it up like you do with your perfume. And just with the same process as before, when you've got some in, get yourself a cloth and just spray it out onto the cloth. Now with this, because it's an alcohol, it's breaking everything down better than the water and the soap. So you only need to do this a couple of times. Give it a good shake, spray it out. Give it a smell. Yeah, all I can smell there is the rubbing alcohol. And again, what I would do on this is, and this is why I prefer the rubbing alcohol, if you give it a spray, it just gets rid of everything that's on there and leaves it perfectly clean and not smelling of the previous perfume that you had in there. So that's it, all clean. Can't smell anything from the previous perfume. This is my preferred technique. However, as I say, using the soapy water technique, that's fine as well. But we've now got two refillable perfume atomizers that can be reused with a new smell that's not going to be contaminated by the previous liquid that was in. So easy to refill, so easy to use, extremely handy to carry around with you when you need it, whether that's on a night out, as I say, getting on the plane, or just if you want to spray some more on throughout the day. Rather than taking a large 100ml bottle, something like that, you don't want to be carrying that around in your handbag or in your pocket. So these are excellent. I'll put the link in below for the original video that I did and the cleaning alcohol, etc. But just so easy to do. These cost about 50p each. So get one of those and just have it on standby. If you're anything like my wife, you want to take a variety of perfume on holiday with you. The only trouble is, if you take your perfume and it's like this one, which is 100ml, if you take three or four of these, you're starting to carry a fair bit of weight, and obviously you're not going to use all that. What we've done is we've bought these, which are perfume atomizers. You just take it and you'll see on the bottom there, it's almost like a gas lighter refill point. And on the top, when you take the lid off, you've got your atomizer spray, which you just press down like that. So that's see-through, so you can see if there's anything in it. Take the top off, pull off the spray, choose the colour of atomizer that you want to go with the particular perfume you've got. And as I said, that there, just like a gas lighter refill, just goes over the top of that. And you just start to go like that, pumping it up and down. So it's already up to that level there. Should see it filling up more and more and more. I think these are about 4 or 5 mil. Right, that's almost filled. I'm not going to put any more in than that. And now this can either go in a handbag to take on board at the airplane or into your normal luggage. And press that down and it'll come out. I'm not going to do it because I'll just get shouted at for wasting a Joe Malone. So instead of five of these size bottles to take away, all we're going to be doing is taking away five of these.